Enots Engineering, I'm Alan. In this week's video, I'm making some small centres to hold a 10mm ball bearing. I'm just using some mild steel bar to make two, and then I'll see if I can turn the taper without altering the tailstock. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it. I've just taken some half inch mild steel bar and I'm turning it down to 12mm. So that should fit on to there. I'll just take the sharp edge off, then I want to put a centre in the end. I'll just face that off again because I've put the phrase up on drilling that hole. Just rub it over with some emery cloth. A 10mm ball bearing that should just fit in there nicely. Now I'm just setting my parting off tool square to the chuck. All I use is a small square on the edge of the chuck and on the edge of the parting off tool.
also just moved the part out of the chuck a bit so that I can now get in to the edge where I've turned and part that off. Turn the part around, all I want to do is face it off. So we have the part with the centering one end, plain on the other end, and that should slide into there. I can tighten this grub screw up and that will hold it in position. So there's the part we've just made, just a centre hole held in the boring head, and I can screw the boring head taper back on. This is the one I made a couple of weeks ago with the number two Morse taper. Now this boring head has one turn for half a mil on the thread. I fitted the boring head into the tailstock. You need to make sure that it's tight in the tailstock, it's not going to twist. And this now gives me a centre, which by turning this Allen key here, will pull across and offset to the original centre. Place a piece of steel in the chuck. All you need to do is center drill . Well I was hoping to show you how it would work, but I can't find a carrier that I can use. What you do is you take the part that you want to turn the taper on. All I've done is put some grease in the end that will hold the ball in position. That goes into, you put a carrier on here. All my carriers have a straight leg. I haven't got any that has the bent leg like this. You put your ball bearing in the end, a bit of lubrication. You shouldn't need much because it's going to go around with the chuck. I've managed to codge up a drive. Three jaw chuck. There's the bar that we center drilled, ball bearing. The components want a machine which has got a center in the end, another center, the ball bearing, and the small little bit of wire I machined first thing, which is grips into the boring head. Now, because my driving dogs are straight, I've had to clamp this one on to give me the drive off the chuck. So now I've got the drive off the chuck going through the bar, and as you can see, the bar is offset because I've moved the boring head across to give me the offset. Now I can turn this and then adjust it with the boring head to give me the correct taper. I'll just turn a little bit because I might want to use a bar for something else. So you can see here, this end, you haven't got to worry about the ball bearing in here, it won't get warm. It's this one that will get warm. I was looking for a very small revolving centre that I could make for the ball bearing in there, so I could fit a revolving centre in this piece, hold the ball bearing, and it wouldn't generate any heat. They are 10mm balls. You could use any size that suits your job. And as you can see from that, you can turn the taper no problem. So you can turn a taper to suit whatever you need and just adjust it by moving the boring head in or out. And because it's got a very fine thread on there compared to your compound slide, or compared to the screws on the tailstock, the adjustment you can make is a lot finer. If you're using centres to turn the taper, pulling the centre over, what happens is it runs on the back of the one and on the front of the other, so it's trying to true itself up, not running truly on the centre that was drilled into it. But if you use ball bearings, the bearing will locate all the way around on both centres because it's like a swiveled joint. So it will locate on both centres on each end and give you a positive location on each ball. So the job should run true all the time. Take light cuts, don't go mad. And just check that this bearing is oiled and lubricated. This one turns with the chuck and the bar. It's this one that gets the heat. So take your time. Don't over clamp with the tailstock. And you should get a good result. Oh well, that's it for today. Hope that was useful. Hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.